the word kin wasn't in my vocabulary. My parents always emphasized that to me.
Somebody tell a kid they can't do something, kid can respond to him, why not?
Why not him? Why not her? Why not anybody to be able to do or achieve anything that they want to achieve?
My focus wasn't always just to be an NBA, but just to be able to do something to make my parents proud.
Because there's really nobody to compare. I'm Russell.
I don't like losing. I don't like being like the second, or always want to be at the top. I don't want to be in the middle, the bottom, average. I just want to always be the top and just try to strive for the best.
Well, at the time, I mean, I didn't think I was going to be where I am today, or playing professionally, or even going to college. So that wasn't my worry. I just was, trying to find a way to get to school.
Did you have the goal at that time of being an NBA player, or?
No, I mean, honestly, that goal didn't come to me until after my first year at UCLA. I just, I didn't think I was gonna make it pro. My only concern was that growing up in inner city, I just didn't want my parents to pay for me to go to school.
With the fourth pick in the 2008 NBA draft, the Seattle Supersonics select Russell Westbrook from UCLA.
This guy was a late bloomer. He did not even start in his high school team until his junior season. Now he's the fourth overall pick.
I'm gonna try my best and go out and, do what I can for the team and try to help him any way I can.
And no one can stop him. He is strong, he is fast. Westbrook, oh my goodness gracious.
Off the turnover, Westbrook on the drive, gets inside and lays it in. Westbrook splits the defense and throws it down.
Even from the beginning, the partnership felt like fireworks.
Westbrook with the thunderous finish. Thank you, Kevin Durant.
And within just 3 years, Kevin Durant and Russell Westbrook were sailing into the finals. And while they'd lose to LeBron's Miami Heatles, it felt like just the beginning of something for Oklahoma City.
I wouldn't want to play with anybody else. I wouldn't want to play for any other city. And hopefully we can get back.
In the summer of 2016, Durant decided he was ready for his next chapter. The NBA waited breathlessly for Russ's response. What they got was an Instagram post that Sports Illustrated later revealed had a hidden message. In the Thunder locker room, cupcake was slang for a soft player. Russ was not just posting a photo of a baked good. It was the opening salvo in a Cold War that would send a chill through the entire league. For months, Westbrook kept the innuendo coming, never outwardly specifically criticizing Durant, but leaving just enough room to let fans infer, then never correcting anyone. And by the time the teams met in Oklahoma City, the hostility was palpable. The cupcake game, when fans flooded the arena with signs, shirts, even a walking cupcake mascot. By the third quarter, this exchange.
The timeout was called, words exchanged, kept saying, I'm coming, I'm coming.
This is how it goes. When I hoop, I have no friends.
Who is he and what is he to you?
Westbrook coming inside, down the lane, and a right-hand thundering dunk.
Doesn't mean that I don't have friends, but during the game, I don't. It's that simple. If you try to be my friend, I ain't gonna say it to you.
Pulls up again, puts it in. Westbrook, the crossover drive, and throws it down.
God has given me a special gift. The way I compete, I think I'm an easy target.
I mean, he is extraordinary, impossibly great. And what did it contribute to winning? Nothing.
In the sports world, I am the bad guy.
Growing up in Los Angeles, Russell's best friend was Kelsey Bars III, who lived across the street. Kelsey had died from an enlarged heart. He was just 16 years old. Russell would go on to play at UCLA, where Kelsey had wanted to play. Today, he still honors his friend.
The anger he plays out there on the court, the aggressiveness Russell plays with, I think a lot of that is just that Kelsey that's in him.
I want everybody to know about Kelsey, you know, how much of a great guy he was and how good he could be.
Just growing up, man, I grew up in inner city, Los Angeles, and growing up, I was never given anything, or nobody never, you know, gave me anything growing up, and I always have to earn everything I've gotten, and that's kind of the only way I know how to play, and the only way I know how to go out there and compete, and that's where the chip comes from.
Could this be the end of Russ as we know him, Russ the superstar? Is Westbrook a championship player?
Well, clearly he's not, because he hasn't won one yet.
You know, when we look at Westbrook, you know, we love his talent. We love the way he competes. But his maturity level and maturation level as a leader and also as a teammate and as a player has definitely been stifled. Westbrook has really stayed stuck on the numbers and not necessarily transcended to the intelligence part of the game, where you need to really be the quarterback and the leader out on the floor to make your team win.
If he could only hit shots, we wouldn't be sitting here dissecting his psychology all the time. If he could just shoot it, but he can't. He's not a good shooter. He had one year where he shot it really well, or for him, 34% from three. But as a volume shooter, he is not a good one. Not only does he take bad shots, but he can't hit good ones oftentimes from the field.
Why do you think you've gotten criticized so much in the press over the years?
I'm not sure. I've realized over the course of the year, regardless of if it's in sports or fashion or whatever it is, if people are talking about you, then you're doing something right.
Yeah.
That's how I feel.
Some records are meant to be broken, but wow.
I know.
Nope. There's not one guy on this planet who can do it. I think that's one of those records that will never be touched.
I don't think that's going to happen either, not for a whole year.
What Oscar did with the triple-double, and that would never happen ever again, never in history of the game.
Definitely. It's up to me to be able to make sure my guys are ready to go, and not just ready, but competing, playing hard. Because playing hard is not an option for me. It's something that we got to take pride in, and to be able to get to the elite level, we got to do that every night.
I think he's going to be the league MVP this year.
When talent, athleticism, passion all meet up at once, you get Russell Westbrook.
What's blowing me away about him isn't just the numbers.
First 50-point triple-double since 1975.
Since Kareem Abdul-Jabbar.
Westbrook with the steal. Jailbreak. What a pass. What a pass. Play of the day. It's all over. Don't even bother. And there is the 38th triple-double.
Probably one of the most powerful triple-doubles we've seen in the modern era, folks.
This was the biggest comeback in Oklahoma City franchise history.
Rebound number 10, the assist, triple-double. Number 41, he has matched Oscar Robertson for the most all-time in a single season.
Thunder's out of timeouts. Deep shot, get it! Perfect ending to a historic day.
And the winner of the 2017 Kia NBA Most Valuable Player Award is Russell Westbrook.
A couple of years ago, if somebody had said to you, do you think it's possible to average a triple-double in the NBA, what you would have thought?
I'd say, why not? That's my motto.
I can tell you growing up, I never thought I'd be even sitting here talking to you, playing in the NBA or anything of this nature. So for me, I take it all in, and to be associated, especially with the club that you're in, it's you know, a complete honor. So I've been a fan of the game since I was little, but you know, I wasn't able to see you play. But to be able to see the numbers and always hear about the big O, you know, I didn't really know
kind of what that meant, but, you know, with the evolution of YouTube and all different things, I was able to kind of see, you know, different things you did for the game. So, you know, that's kind of when I first heard about, you know, heard about you.
I first saw you play at UCLA. Sometimes in college, you don't get to see what a player can really do. Your progress has been remarkable.
Appreciate it.
What you've done has been historic. I applaud you for it.
Thank you.
And it's wonderful that you've been able to get the people rallied around what you've done.
Yeah.
Fans really got behind it. I mean, everywhere.
All right.
They were rooting for you to do these things.
For me, it was overwhelming, honestly. Going on the road and getting the reaction from the crowds, the fans from all over, you know, following the triple double, following the chase. It was kind of crazy, man, and for me and for my teammates, it was a blessing to kind of see that evolve.
Never stopped. You know, I was been grinding my whole life, man. I've been grinding, never was given anything. I've been blessed with a great talent to play basketball, man, and I'm you know, honored to be able to be in Oklahoma City and come out and compete every single night. And my job is to never stop, regardless of percentages. I don't really give a damn about percentages, honestly. All I care about is wins. As long as we win, that's all I care about.
Got some breaking news on SportsCenter. The NBA stealing all the headlines again. Our man Adrian Wojnarowski reporting Russell Westbrook on his way to Houston. The Thunder agreeing to trade the eight-time All-Star to the Rockets for Chris Paul.
But both the team and Westbrook are ready to move on. And I'm told they'd like to try to find something sooner than later. They don't want this to drag out.
Oh, with a smash.
There was a feeling mutually that there was kind of it was maybe a time for both sides to move on.
Rockets have agreed to trade Russell Westbrook to Washington for John Wall and a protected first in 2023.
For me, I take pride every single night and leaving it all on the floor. I honestly believe there is no player like myself. If people want to take it for granted, sorry for them. But I'm pretty sure if everybody could do it, they'll do it. I don't care what nobody thinks about it. I take a lot of pride in taking care of my body. I take a lot of pride in competing every night. I don't take nights off. I don't cheat the game.
The Washington Wizards agreeing to send that man, Russell Westbrook, to the Lakers.
He's a future Hall of Famer and one of the best players in the NBA, but his trade to the Lakers now lands him on his fourth team in 4 years, leading some people to wonder why he moves around so much.
Westbrook off the glass, badly misses. You hear the groans from the crowd. He's hearing some boos. Not the first time this year. Westbrook thought about it. Crowd kind of telling him no.
Russell Westbrook looks broken. And when I say that, I never seen him lack this much confidence as a player. Forget the shooting. His spirit is just not there.
Kevin Durant was your teammate. James Harden, Serge Ibaka, Victor Oladipo, Paul George, James Harden again, Bradley Beal, and now LeBron James and Anthony Davis. If you end your career with zero championship, with all of those dudes as your teammate, that's a damn problem.
Yeah, Russell, do you feel like you have anything to prove?
No, I don't. When I got drafted in the NBA, that was me proving people wrong. If I go to college, go to UCLA from the inner city, that was me proving people wrong. Just making it out the hood was proving people wrong. I don't need to do that anymore. I've been able to bless the people around me, my family, been able to impact people all across the world with this platform that's been given to me, and I'm continue to do that. And obviously we want to win a championship, but our ultimate goal is to make sure we use what we have to impact others around you.
Have you run into anybody playing today, younger players, that have that same fire, that same passion that you have for the game?
Westbrook plays mean.
Oh, with a vicious slam!
He played mean like I did, with an aggression, much the way I play.
Things that we've talked about, me and him, you know, just the potential of me being able to be a Laker and understanding what that entails. And, you know, it's just crazy to think about, you know.
It's one time going into my sophomore season at UCLA, and a lot of pickup games at UCLA would happen, and a lot of superstars would come. But this particular day, Kobe came, and I'm super hyped, and I'm just excited to compete. But the number one lesson I got in that is that watching him, and to this day, I think we all know it as the Mamba mentality, but when I was younger and watching him, he was competing like it was the finals. And to me, it was so inspiring because it allowed me to understand, like, this is what you need to be like, regardless of where you at, what you're doing, however you playing. And I took that attitude and ran with it.
Kobe Bryant didn't bless a lot of people with the Mamba mentality. And it's only a few people that I've seen, that I've witnessed, that plays every possession. Not every minute, every second, every possession. That's what Russell Westbrook do.
Thing that kind of brought us together is being able to compete and not being able to take nights off. But we began to have a better relationship off the floor as brothers and talking about other things outside of basketball and things that we've been able, can able to do with this game. And to me, that is the most important thing I've been able to cherish from Kobe that I will continue to cherish and live on.
With the ball, Utah now. Their bench is just 2 out of 12 from beyond the arc.
Russ! Throw it down!
Paint has been exploding. Did he ever explode over the top of Gobert?
I love to play basketball, and I love the game. I want to be the best, and I feel like to be the best, you gotta take pride in every possession, every time somebody even may score on you or you may turn the ball over or whatever it may be. You have to take pride in it and you know, take it on the chest and try to find a way to fix it.
I know that the game is not promised to me. I know tomorrow's not promised to me at all. So every time I step on the floor, I give everything I have and then, you know, I wake up the next day and do the same thing again.
I don't really care what nobody else thinks about my game. As long as I'm okay, I'm satisfied with what I do and bring to the table. I'm gonna keep busting everybody and we'll figure it out after that. Every year, I try to find ways to come back and be better and add different things to my game and you know, try to do the impossible. Everybody can always say, like, well, when I see him play, he leaves it out on the floor every night. I mean, that's what drives me to be better.
Westbrook goes to the rim and sticks the dagger.